We're going to talk about the area between curves. Previously, you learned about how to find area under a curve. You found that you could divide a region from A to B under a curve f of x up into small rectangles. And for each rectangle, you could look at a point in that rectangle, x of k star, and then you could look at the height of the rectangle to be f of x of k star. So that gives you the height of the rectangle. And then the width of the rectangle was delta x. And then that could all be combined together to give you the Riemann sum, adding up from rectangle number 1 to rectangle number n, of the height f of x sub k star times the width delta x. Height times width is going to give you the area of the rectangle. And then the summation is going to add up the area of all those rectangles between A and B. And then we took the limit as n went to infinity to increase the number of rectangles. And that turned into the integral from A to B of f of x dx. So that method of taking a region and slicing it up into rectangles, finding the area of each rectangle, and then summing them and turning it into an integral, we're going to call that the slicing method. In this course, we're going to be applying the slicing method to a lot of new things other than just area under a curve. The first thing we're going to look at is area between curves. So what if we have not just one curve, but two curves? And we want to find the area between those two curves. Well, we can still divide up into rectangles. The rectangle will still have a point in it, x sub k star, that we're interested in, and it will still have a width of delta x. But now the height of this rectangle is going to be given by subtracting the top value, which in this case would be f of x sub k star, from the bottom value, which is g of x sub k star. To find a vertical distance on a graph, we subtract the top from the bottom, the biggest y value from the smallest y value. And so, to find the area of this rectangle, we're going to have f of x sub k star minus g of x sub k star all times delta x. That gives us the area of one rectangle. Now we're going to sum them all up, k starting at 1, the first rectangle, and ending at n. And we're going to again take the limit as n goes to infinity to increase the number of rectangles to get the exact area between the curves. Just like before, this is going to turn into a integral. The limit of the sum becomes the integral from A to B, and the delta x becomes the dx at the end. And in the middle, the f of x sub k star becomes f of x, and the g of x sub k star becomes g of x. So to find the area between two curves from A to B, we're going to just subtract the top function minus the bottom function, and then integrate. Sometimes we have what we call compound regions. These are regions where if we start drawing little vertical lines as rectangles, for a while we have one function on the bottom, here it's h of x, and a different function on top, here it's f of x, and then all of a sudden it changes. So in this graph, it changes right here. Now these green rectangles, when I draw them in, the bottom function is still h of x, but the top function is a new function g of x. This means that our top function is changing. We can split up our region right here. And for each of these smaller regions, we know how to find the area between the curves by subtracting the top function from the bottom function, but we're going to split this area up at this point B so that we can actually compute each region separately. So what this is going to look like is we're going to need to do the integral from A to B of our top function, so in this case that's f of x for the red region, minus our bottom function, which is h of x for the red region, dx, and then we're going to add to that the integral from b to c of our new top function. So for the green region, that's g of x minus the same bottom function as before, h of x dx. So the important thing here is whenever you're looking at what your little rectangles would be, if the top function or the bottom function changes, you need to make a new integral. It's the only way you can account for there being a different top or bottom function. Sometimes we're given a region where it just looks like it would be really difficult to split it up into vertical rectangles. And we look at that and we say, I wish I could draw horizontal rectangles instead. It would be so much easier that way. And the good thing is we actually can. So here is an example where we can do horizontal rectangles. When we're doing horizontal rectangles, we're still going to do rectangles all the way from the bottom to the top. Here, where we're going to start our rectangles is given by a y value c, and where we're going to stop is given by a y value d. And our typical point for our rectangle is a y value, y sub k star. So if we give these functions names, these will be functions in terms of y and not in terms of x. So this could be f of y, and this one could be g of y. Then this point would be g of y sub k star. And this point would be f of y sub k star. And the difference between those two points would be the length, the height of this rectangle. Height is a weird word here because it's sideways, but it would still be the length of that rectangle would be given by, now we're going to start with the right side, g of y sub k star, and we're going to do that because this is a bigger value on the x-axis, minus f of y sub k star. That gives us that length. And then the width of this rectangle, it's very little, I don't know if you can see there, is now delta y. It's how much y changes for that one little rectangle. And again, we're going to add up all the rectangles, starting at rectangle 1, k being 1, and going to n, and taking the limit as n goes to infinity. So this is actually going to turn into an integral in terms of y. We're going to integrate from c to d of g of y minus f of y, and the delta y becomes dy. So notice everything here now is in terms of y. So this is just the same idea as what we did before, only we're switching the roles of x and y. So to use this, you need to have your functions solved as functions of y. And whenever we're doing things with horizontal rectangles, whenever we're trying to find a horizontal distance, it's always going to be right, because the right side gives us a bigger number, minus left.